And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. We've got baseball on the show. It's the Miami Marlins and the Milwaukee Brewers. First pitch coming your way next. Just about set, and on the mound in this one, Brandon Woodruff. Base runners are tough to come by with him out there, Chris.
Well, he's been a real quality starter for his club, and coming into this one, what stands out for me is that right-handed hitters have really struggled batting below 200 on the year. It seems that they have a hard time picking up his release point and tracking the ball into the zone. So we'll see how right-handers do against him in this one.
The 1-1. Fought off foul. Swings through it for the K. Some high cheese for strike three. Josh Bell at the plate now. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Caratini makes the grab. Two down. And time now for the Marlins lineup. The sluggers in this lineup might not be too happy about the fact that the wind is blowing in today, Chris.
Yeah, and you hear pitchers talk about how good it feels when the wind is at their back. And for hitters, you almost feel like beyond just the pitcher coming at you, you've got this other force coming against you. So important to try to get on top of the ball in terms of hitting line drives, you know, maybe really hard ground balls with a good exit velocity that'll get you a base hit, because it's very frustrating. You just hit one on the screws, think it's going to go out of the ballpark, and a guy is camped underneath it in front of the warning track. He wanted that fastball high and tight, looking for a strikeout, just didn't locate it very well.
And down on strikes, and good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Miami down in order. Now it's the Brewers' turn. It's a scoreless ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Here at American Family Field. And on the hill in this one, Yuri Perez.
Well, what quickly stands out to me for this guy is that he comes in with a 3-1 strikeout to walk ratio on the season. So when you consider consistency, the ability to get swings and misses, and to limit base runners, that's critical in winning games today, especially when teams are depending on the big swing, the home run, to win ball games.
Here's the Brewers lineup put together by Craig Counsell. And no doubt a big factor in this series so far, Andrew Monasterio.
Well, Boog, there aren't many guys who have a flair for the big moment like he does. I mean, batting over 400 with runners in scoring position, are you kidding me? I know it's not guaranteed or an automatic, but I hope we get to see him in a close late-game situation with runners in scoring position and just see, is he truly a machine or not?
Pulls it down and there's two gone. And now it's the switch hitter, Carlos Santana. Into center. And that'll do it. We move to the second in Milwaukee. No score. Top of the second. Now it's the DH, Ryan De La Cruz. And here it comes. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. 2013 in the playoffs, you caught one as the Red Sox played the Rays in the division series.
I sacrificed a bracelet. It was my wrist and my hand.
Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Blew the express right by his bat for strike three. So up next, number 54. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. No score here in the second. Swing and a ball popped up. And puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two.
Well, off to a great start. He's really cruising out there on the mound. He's got a chance to get through these first two innings with under 20 pitches. That could set him up to go deep into this game.
Yuli Gurriel in the box now. No balls and a strike. This one popped up. And Gurriel is out. And that will end the inning. And 1-2-3 go the Marlins. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here in Milwaukee. Bottom half of inning number two. Up now for Milwaukee. Mark Canna.
Canna.
The pitch. Now he turns and heads for second. And he's into scoring position with a leadoff double. Maybe a chance for our first run here.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. If you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. What a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't close at all. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Righty delivers. And there's a foul ball. Canna stands in second with no outs. In the air, out towards right center. And they get Adames for the out. Runner tags at second. And the throw's offline, safe at third. Now the third baseman, Andrew Monasterio. Right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two down. Vic Caratini at the plate. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Bell under it. And that is that. Brewers strand one. We'll move to the third with no score. And welcome back. Jazz Chisholm Jr. now. And a pitch. That one misses. 1-0. Chisholm in his third season, 25 years old, and he was born in the Bahamas. Next offering is fouled back. And that's off the inside edge. Two balls and a strike. Popped up. Terang hauls it in, and there's one away. John Birdie at the plate. Good defender. He's been inconsistent offensively. And a foul ball. And he deals. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. He's there, he's got it. Two down.
Well, that's what he's looking for with the fastball above the zone. A swing and miss or weak contact.
And first offering is fouled off. Top of the third, no score. Next offering is fouled back. Foul ball, he stays alive. And the righty deals. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. That's foul off to the right side, keeps the AB going.
Such a tough time putting him away. Six foul balls in a row. Man, what a battle.
Next offering upstairs. And that one hit 97 on the gun. Enough to do it for the Marlins. Still no score. Welcome back. Set for the bottom of the third. This is Bryce Terang. Pitch on the ground. Birdie, the throw to first, one gone, bottom of the third inning. Now the left fielder, Tyrone Taylor. And that's gonna roll to the wall.
swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Digging in, Sal Frelick. Line drive. He makes the grab. Runner tagging for third. The tag gets him, and it's a double play to end the inning.
Exciting play and a great throw to third for the double play, but man, there's just no reason to try to move up to third right there. Not great base running to end the inning.
On to the fourth, here's Garrett Hampson. Garrett Woodruff back to work. This one popped up, foul ground first base side. Caratini takes it in for the out, and there's one down. And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Santana makes the grab for the second out.
Ball's just not carrying the first tonight.
Now, you would actually say that to your teammate in the dugout?
No, I'm not that cruel, but someone would say it to me, and I'm sure it's probably been said before.
The wind of the pitch. Foul ball there. Swings and misses, struck him out. And the Marlins down quietly, and we're still knotted at zero. Bottom of the fourth, and now it's William Contreras. Pitch. In the air, left field. And there's one down. Carlos Santana up now for the Brewers. Lied out his first time. Pulls that one foul. Yoan. That one out to right. Hauls it in for the out. Here's Mark Canna, doubled his first time up. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Grabs it on the run. And that is that. Brewers go down quietly, and we are still scoreless. We go to the top of the fifth. Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Brian De La Cruz. Foul back our way, and that's out of play.
You know, these Marlins just aren't putting together very many good at-bats in this one. We're in the back half of the game, and they're still searching for a base runner. He's been great out there on the mound, no doubt. But it's also been a disappointing performance at the plate to this point.
Sit down on strikes. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. Here's the left fielder, number 54. Next pitch is popped up. Two away.
And as we get deeper, it's not going to get any easier. These at-bats are going to feel more and more desperate with every out the rest of the way.
In the air, out towards left center. Taylor makes the grab, and that's the inning. Miami down in order. Halfway through this one, still no score. Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Up now for Milwaukee, Willie Adames. Now the right-hander ready to go. Still no score. And first offering is fouled off. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Chisholm gets under it. And it's caught for the out. Here's the third baseman, Andrew Monasterio. 0 for 1 with a flyout. Left field, way back there. That's back. Makes the catch up against the wall.
Thought that was a no-doubter. Like the wind was holding that in this ballpark.
Victor Caratini up now for the Brewers. Swung on, belted. That's back there. Banks off the wall. Now a relay to second, but he's in there easily.
He was all over that one. First pitch fastball in a great spot to do some damage, and he squared it up nicely. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
In the air, left side. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. And that will end the inning. Milwaukee leads one. Sixth inning coming up, still nothing on the scoreboard. Back here in Milwaukee, and now Jazz Chisholm Jr. Woodruff back to work. And there's a strike. Some nuggets on Jazz Chisholm. He's from the Bahamas, and he was born in 1998, signed with the Diamondbacks in 2015. Before he could make his major league debut, though, Arizona traded Jazz to Miami for Zach Gallen. He made his debut the following season, and then in 2022, he became an All-Star. Swing and a miss, struck him out. The high heat, too much on that one. Now it's the second baseman, John Birdie. He's 0 for 1.
John Birdie.
And first offering is fouled off.
He also became the first player from the Bahamas to play a game at shortstop in the bigs since Andre Rogers in 1967. You know, Rogers, the first big leaguer from the Bahamas, started to play shortstop for the Cubs when Ernie Banks moved to first base.
Swing and a miss. 1-2. Swing and a ball popped up. Santana snags it for the second out. Nick Fortes, the next up for the Marlins. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. The Marlins yet to pick up a hit here. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. So he's perfect through six. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. And we still have no score. Back here at American Family Field, John Schoppe with Chris Singleton in the booth, and leading off the bottom of the sixth, Tyrone Taylor. And the pitch. Missed to center field. Chisholm makes the grab, one pitch and one out. And stepping in is the speedy Sal Frelin. Line drive, base hit right field. So a man aboard now with one away.
Waste no time there. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock. And now let's see if they force some action with good wheels on the bases.
And a base hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out. Next for Milwaukee, Carlos Santana.
So clutch, you could argue that he's been this team's MVP this year.
And first offering is fouled off.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play move.
And he'll one. That one fouled off. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. And that one is gone. Carlos Santana powers one out. Home run number 20 of the year. Just like that, they move in front. It's 3-0.
No matter how this outing ends, that pitch is going to haunt him for a while. An 0-2 mistake. That's supposed to be a pitch out of the zone. He left it in the spot that the hitter could do some damage with, and that's exactly what he did.
So digging in, Mark Canna, 1-for-2. Liner, base hit.
Ford hits in a row, and they're really swinging it here. Ripped out one down the line and kept it fair. And even when you hit it that far out front, you still have to keep your hands tight to your body so you don't hook around that baseball and put it in foul territory. And that right there was perfect.
So the Marlins go with a new arm, number 33.
And this is his 55th game he's come in to pitch this season, so he's got some innings under his belt. He's been an important guy for them.
Willy Adames stands in. Out of line, out towards center. He's got it, there's two away. Next for the Brewers, Andrew Monasterio.
Almost drove one out of here last time up. Slide out to the warning track.
Puts a bunt down. Gurriel. And they put the tag on him. That's the third out, inning over. The Brewers add three on this blast. It's now 3-0. Back after this on the show. New inning getting started. And the batter will be the shortstop, Garrett Hampson. Popped up right side. Terang pulls it in on the run.
He's been going after these guys consistently, and as a result, he's been able to keep his pitch count low, throwing the ball very well right now.
And first offering is fouled off. Swing and a ball popped up. Terang settles under it and makes the catch. Two up, two down. Jake Berger, the next up for the Marlins. And he swings and misses at the initial offer. The Fish still looking for their first hit in this one. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. Stays alive. The wind of the pitch. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Enough to do it for the Marlins. They trail in this one, 3-0. And welcome back. Here's the catcher, Victor Caratini. The pitch. Fly ball down the line. Number 54, gliding to his right, makes the catch, and there's one gone. And now Bryce Terang. Line to second, snagged on the bounce. Birdie fires over to first. Awesome play there. Up now for Milwaukee, Tyrone Taylor. In the air, left field. That ends the inning. Nobody left for Milwaukee, but they lead it 3-0. Welcome back. We're at the top of the eighth, and at the plate for Miami, Brian De La Cruz. First pitch just misses. Woodruff into his eighth inning of work, Ziggy. He's been good.
Yeah, he's the type of guy that gets better as he gets deeper into the ballgame. If you're going to get to him, you get to him early. They didn't do that today. We'll see what happens as this finishes.
And he's now just five outs away. He's got a real shot at this thing.
Yeah, bro, he is rolling just in one of those grooves where he looks pretty unbeatable today.
Swing and a pop-up. Makes the grab on the run.
And there's two away. And he's getting really close to this thing right now. Only four outs left, but it's going to be tough to get.
Gurriel stands in here. Tried to hold back his swing there, but went around.
Have you ever caught a foul ball as a fan?
Only as a broadcaster, not as a fan. You?
I've been in many games as a fan.
Marlins hitless so far in the game. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball.
Wow, he got a really mistake right there.
Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Foul ball. It stays nothing at two. Got him looking. Fastball, the letters frozen for strike three. And 1-2-3 go the Marlins. They trail it here 3-0. Righty reliever out of the pen, David Robertson.
Left-handed batter at the plate, and he's been excellent in those matchups this year, so this seems like a calculated move.
Here comes a pitch. There's a swing and a drive. Back there. Made a pay for that one, and they tack on to their lead. It's 4-0.
Welcome to the game. First pitch out of the bullpen, a tough one. And you know he's just trying to get one in there for a strike. And on the other side, as a hitter, it's a great time to be aggressive and let it fly. It's not what they were looking for when they turned to him, but now he's got to find a way to reset.
Here's the Brewers DH, William Contreras, 1-for-3. And that one hammered. Way back there. Out of here. His 16th homer of the year, and they add on. It's 5-0. He absolutely feasts on right-handed pitching and devours that one for a homer.
And you can see that's what he expects of himself. At bat after at bat, he's that confident.
And now the first baseman, Carlos Santana. He's already homered here in this one. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Here comes the 0-1. High fly ball, right field. Bell under it. And there's one away. Number 62 on the pinch out of the pen here.
I think it's got to be a little tough coming in out of the pen when your guys are trailing so big on the scoreboard. Just doesn't have the same intensity to it, but he's got to find a way because these batters count the same for his stats, obviously, regardless of the score.
Tracks it down for the out. That's out number two. Two outs, bases empty. Willie Adames up now for the Brewers. There's a line drive to left field. Makes a nice running catch. And that is that. Brandon Woodruff, perfect so far. We'll see if he can make history as we head to the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one. And now for the Marlins, Jazz Chisholm Jr. There's the strike.
Dude, I'll tell you right now, every player defensively on their toes like never before.
Next offering is fouled back.
They want to make sure they have the opportunity to put this pitcher in the history books. They are going to make the play.
The punch out there, and he's down on strikes for the second time today. John Birdie, the next up for the Marlins. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Takes it in for the out.
26 up and 26 down. One more out for a perfect game. This is awesome move.
On the verge of baseball history here, and certainly one of the most dominating pitching performances we've seen. Everyone locked in right now. 0-2 now. Good job to fight that one off.
You know, he's been so great today. Really just throwing whatever the catcher puts down. I mean, hasn't shaking off the catcher very much at all today.
And he rings him up, calls strike three. It's a perfect game.
Just unbelievable. I was nervous up here in the booth. I can only imagine what his teammates and even he felt out there on the mound closing his thing out. Everyone will remember this perfect game, and it'll be notched in Cooperstown forever.